Hello, it's Stephen Kelly here from Southwest Survival, and what we're going to go through today is our second lesson in the navigational training. So what we're going to talk about today is identifying your own position. So yesterday we talked about orientation and how to orientate your map to ground. So when you've got your orientation, you want to find exactly where you are on the ground. So this is what we're going to go through today. So the aim of this lesson is to teach you how to relate map to ground, just what I've already talked about. So in map reading, you use most of these skills to identify locations or to follow routes. So you can already use these skills anyway going. So you use your maps and grids. You look at the ground shape. So you look at, is that a saddle? Is that a spear? Is that a re-entrance? You're already looking at the ground to relate yourself to the map. Bearings, GMA and compass work. And like I said, we're going to start going through all these a bit more throughout the series. Measuring distance. But suppose you don't know where you are and how you are going to identify your position. So you don't know exactly where you are. So this is a thing we use in the military. All right. So the following process should always be used. And some of you who's watching this video now might already know this. So the first thing you need to do is study the ground. Set the map by orientation using what we taught on our last episode. Apply DD craft. And this is what we're going to go through today. And then identify your position. And remember, do not guess where you are. So here's us now looking on the ground. There's us on the ground looking forward. And what we can see is a mast. So as you can see there on our map, we're somewhere here, but we don't know exactly where we are. To our north, we can see a mast. Now this is us on the ground. We're somewhere here. To our north, we can see a mast. So the first thing we want to do is get our direction. So remember this mnemonic, DD Crafts, you want to get your direction. And how you can get your direction is using the compass straight away. So you know your north, south, east and west. Then you can orientate your map. So that's the first thing we're going to do now. Then we're going to look at distance. So let's make up a little story now. So what I mean by direction is I've got my map. All right, and I'm relating my map to ground. And I'm looking forward and I can see the mast on the horizon. And I'm looking at my map, I've looked at my compass, and I know that's north. In front of me, there's a main road in front of me, 300 metres. And that's running from east to west. So I've related my map to ground in line with the mast in the distance and to that main road running from east to west in front of me. And the distance away, I know I'm roughly 300 metres away from that main road. So I'm looking back now 300 metres from that road to find out exactly where I am. So I've got my direction, using north, south, east, west, using my compass. I've got my distance, I've made up my story now. I'm 300 metres back from that main road. That main road is running from east to west on my map, and it's running from east to west in front of me. I'm going to start looking for conventional signs. And what I mean by that is, can I see a phone box? Can I see pylons? Can I see a church? Can I see a pub? Can I see anything what's going to give me information? Whatever's on the map, I want to relate that to the ground. So I'm looking for conventional signs. And then I'm looking for relief. So let's keep that story going all the time. So I've got my direction, north, south, east and west, using the compass, or I've used the ground. I know that road's running from east to west. Distance, I'm 300 metres back from that road. Looking on the ground, I can see a church with a spire to my left, and I can see a mast to my right. Looking on my map, I can see a church with a spire to my left and a mast to my right. I'm breaking it down. Relief, what can I see? What can I see on the ground? I can see an even slope to my left. I can see a saddle to my right. I look back on my map. I can see an even slope to my left. I can see a saddle to my right. I'm breaking it down. Now I'm finding exactly where I am. Alignment. What can I see in a line from me to that mast? So what I do is I get my map and I know I'm roughly on this bearing, right? I can see the mast in the distance and I can positively identify that mast on the map. But I don't know exactly where I'm standing. So I'll look at the mast, I'll line the mast up on the map with my compass and in one line, and I come backwards. And on the ground, I can see in a line, I can see a farmhouse, I can see a church, I can see a wood complex, and I'm looking on the map like that, and I'm looking on the ground, and I'm like, yes, I can identify that. What I'm seeing on the ground, in a line, on the map, coming backwards, yeah, I can see that wood, I can see that wood. I can see that farm, I can see that mast all in one line, and that's how we use the alignments. And then I'm looking to the left of it, what is to the left of that line? right, there's another wood block, or there's a hospital, look on the ground with your binoculars. Yes, I can see a wood block, I can see a hospital. To the right of me alignment, what can I see to the right of it? Oh, I can see a post office, I can see a river. Get my binos out. Yeah, on this line, to the right of it, I can see a river, I can see a post office. And that's how we're using alignment. Proximity. Now, to the left of me, in the proximity of the church, I can see a phone box, looking at it. I can see a wood block. I can see a school. I can see that looking out on the ground. Now, I look at my map. In the proximity of that church, I can see a phone box. I can see a school. I can see a wood block. So I'm narrowing it down. So I know, yeah, I'm definitely here. And the last thing we talk about when it comes to DD craps is shape. So what I mean by that, a lot of people get shape mistaken with relief. Relief is the shape of the ground. Shape is the shape of, well, how can I say this? Buildings, wood blocks, rivers. So I can prominently see on the ground a T-shaped building. I'll go back and look at my map now. I can see a T-shaped building. I can see an L-shaped wood block on the ground. Looking for my binoculars, look at my map. I can see an L-shaped wood block. Let's put all this together now, dead quick. So direction, I've used my compass, I've found north. I've related my map to grounds by orientating my map, found north. My distance, I can see a road in front of me 300 metres away, running from east to west, all right? Look on my map, yeah, there's a road 300 metres in front of me running from east to west. Conventional signs, I can see on the ground, I can see a church 200 metres away. Right, so 300 metres back from that church, or 300 metres back from that main road, I can see a church. Happy days, look on the ground. Yeah, I can see a church on the ground, and it's, I can relate it to my map. Relief, to the right of me, I can see a saddle. Look on my map, to the right, I can see a saddle. Alignment, in my line, from me all the way up to that mast, I can prominently identify on the map, and I can relate to the ground. In that line, straight on the line, I can see a wood block, I can see a farm complex, I can see pylons. Look on the ground, yeah, I can see a wood block, I can see a farm complex, I can see pylons, and that relates to the ground exactly the same to my map. Proximity, to my right, in the proximity of that church complex, there is what I can see on the ground. I can see mast, I can see pylons, I can see a school. Look on my map, mast, pylon, school. And the shape, right in front of me, I can see a T-shaped wood block. Look on my map, right in front of me, I can see a T-shaped wood block. That's you comfortable now, you know exactly where you are using DD craps. Hopefully I haven't baffled you too much. If you want some more. So that's the theory side of it, what we've just went through now. So we're going through DD craps, direction, distance, conventional signs, relief, alignment, proximity, and shape. What we're going to go through now is a little practical session. So that's us at the X. Oh. That's us at the X. What I want you to do now is I want you to use DD craps in your own time, sitting in the comfort of your own home using this. So I'll leave it on for a few seconds and I want you to go through the mnemonic DD craps and just send me a picture, whether that be on Facebook, Instagram, reply back in the comments how you've used it. But as you can see here, this is you on the ground, you're at that X. How would you use DD craps now? How would you get your direction? What would you use your distance to? What conventional signs can you see? What type of relief can you see? Alignment, what will you align yourself up with? Proximity. Shape. And that's it. But like I said, thank you very much for tuning in. Hopefully you've got some value from this and you've learned something new. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. All likes and comments and feedback is much appreciated. As you can see, I'm just trying to grow my channel and offer some feedback and value to all yous. But stay safe and see you all soon. Bye.